Hi all, welcome to the session on the topic AWT controls. The main objectives of today's session are to demonstrate AWT controls like labels, push button, checkboxes and checkbox group. In order to clearly understand this session, you should have knowledge about event handling in Java, what is AWT and AWT classes, and also the class hierarchy of java.awt package. So you have to watch the previous video sessions of module 5 and first session of AWT in module 6. So what is AWT? AWT means Abstract Window Toolkit. It is an API which provides graphical user interface. And this API provides various controls like label, button, checkbox, choice list, scroll bar, text field, text area. What are these controls? Controls are actually components that allow a user to interact with the application. And all the controls are subclasses of component class. So the controls are components and it allows user to interact with the application. And all these controls should be added to container windows. And this is the class hierarchy. We have already familiarized this class hierarchy in the first session of AWT. And in order to use the AWT, we have to import java.awt package. And this package provides classes for various components like text field, label, text area, radio button, etc. And if you look at this figure, at the top of this hierarchy is object, then comes the component class. All the control classes are subclasses of component, and container is also a subclass of component. Container has several subclasses like window, panel, applet, frame, etc. So container is also a component, and container can hold the components that are added to it. Then how to add and remove controls to a window. In order to include a control to a window, we have to call add method, and that is defined in the container class. We have to use add method. Within the add method, we have to give the object of the component. So if a component is added to a window, that component is automatically visible when the parent window is displayed. To remove that control, we have to call the remove method, also defined in the container class. General form is void remove, then give the reference of that component. Then how the events are handled, how Java will respond to control events. So except for label, which is a passive control, all other controls generate events. And these events are accessed by, these controls are accessed by the user. When user interact with these controls, events are generated. And label is a passive control, it will not create any event. So suppose for example, if you click a button, an event will be generated. And an event is sent to the listener who have registered with that source. So in order for event handling to work, our program should implement the appropriate interface, and we have to register an event listener, and only registered event listeners will get notification about that event. All these things we have studied in delegation event modeling. Once a listener has been installed, events are automatically sent. So then we will see each control in detail. First is label. Label is an object of type label. It contains a string which it displays. They are passive controls. They do not support any interaction with the user. And there are mainly three constructors. First one is just creates a label with no string or no name for that label. Second one creates a label with a string. That string is the name of that label. Third one with the two arguments, string and alignment. Alignment may be label.left or label.right or label.center. That means we can specify where that label to be displayed in the window. whether it is displayed in the left side of the window or in the middle or to the right window. So first version creates a blank label, second version creates a label with the name str and automatically left justified. Third version creates a label and we can specify the alignment using variable alignment, using argument alignment. Then methods associated with the label, set text and get text. We can set or change the text in a label by using set text method, and if you want to access or obtain the current label we can use get text. Similarly, we can set alignment of a label string by using set alignment, and if you want to retrieve the current alignment we can use get alignment method. So the four main methods supported by label class are label control are set text, get text, set alignment and get alignment. This is a program to demonstrate labels. In this program we are creating three labels and we are adding labels to applet window. So in order to create an applet window we need to import AWT package and applet package. The code, applet code, class name is label demo, and our class should extend applet. Then inside init method we are creating three labels. How to create a label? Label name of the label is equal to new label. Here we are giving the string, that is name to be displayed on the label is 1, second label name is 2 and third label name is 3. Next thing is, we have created these three labels, we have to add these labels to any window. Here we are adding labels to an applet window. So add 1, add label 2, add label 3. Then we have to compile this program and we can run this program using applet viewer. So if you give applet viewer label demo, applet window get displayed. This is the output of the program. In the applet window three labels are displayed, 1, 2 and 3. Next control is button, and most widely used control, button control is push button, and it have a label associated with this. And the most important thing is it generates an event when it is clicked or pressed. That event name is action event. So action event is an event generated when we press a button, and it has two constructors, button and second version is it creates a button that contains str as a label, and first version creates an empty button without any label. So first method is set label. We can set the label of button by passing a string. Second method is get label. Then event associated with button is action event. So we have to register a listener with that button control. Only if it is registered, and when an event is raised a notification will be sent. And we have to implement which interface? Action listener interface. And inside that interface there is a method, action performed method. We have to define that method, and that method is invoked when the action event is raised. So the important things are, when you press a button action event is generated, and we have to implement action listener interface, and we have to define the action performed method. Then when an event is raised, action event object is supplied to the listener. That object is a reference to the button that generated the event, and also have a reference to command string associated with the button. And by default the command string associated with a button is label of the button itself. Suppose we have created three button labeled add, save and cancel. Each time a button is pressed, we have to display a message that report which button has been pressed. So when a button is pressed, the action event will be raised, and action command of the button will be label, default label. Suppose if we press add button, then action command will be label add. If you click save button, action command will be save label. Similarly, if you click cancel button, action command string will be cancel label. So this is an example program that demonstrates how to add three buttons named add, save and cancel to an applet window. So our class extends applet, button demo class extends applet. Inside the init method, we are creating three buttons A, B, C. First button with add label, second button with the save label, third button with the cancel label. Next thing is the created components should be added to the applet window. So we have to add button A, B and C. If you run that applet using applet viewer, we will get the output like this. There will be three buttons named add, save and cancel. So in this program, we are just displaying three buttons. We are not handling events associated with that button. Which interface? Action listener interface. Here we are implementing action listener interface. So we have to define the method action performed method of action listener interface. To this method action performed method, and get action command will return the label cancel, and the message you pressed cancel will be displayed. Next control is checkbox. Checkbox is a control that is used to turn an option on or off. We can tick a checkbox or untick a checkbox. It is a small box that contains a check mark, and every checkbox will have a label associated with that, and you can change the state of a checkbox by clicking on it. There are five constructors. First one, a constructor with no argument. Second one, receives string argument. Third one, a boolean variable. And fourth one, there is a checkbox group. And default state of a checkbox is unchecked. Third form allows you to set the initial state of the checkbox. If on is true, the checkbox is initially checked, otherwise it is cleared. Fourth and fifth forms create a checkbox whose label is specified by str and whose group is specified by CB group. CB group is the group of the checkbox. If this checkbox is not part of a group, CB group must be null. To retrieve the current state of a checkbox, we have to call getState, and to set the state of the checkbox, we have to call setState. You can obtain the label associated with the checkbox by calling getLabel method, and in order to set the label of a checkbox, use setLabel method. So boolean getState will return the current state of the checkbox. If you want to set a state, if you want to make it checked, we have to pass boolean value as true, and if you want to set the label of any checkbox, you have to pass string in the setLabel method. Then next is how to handle events associated with the checkbox. So when a checkbox is selected or deselected, an item event is generated. So associated with button, we have action event. Associated with the checkbox, we have item event. And that will be sent to listeners that are registered with checkbox. So here we have to implement item listener interface. In the case of button, we are implementing action listener interface. In order for item event, we have to implement item listener interface, and we have to define item state changed method, and to that method an item event object is passed as argument, and that object contains information about the event, that is whether the checkbox is selected or deselected. So this is a program which demonstrates checkbox and event associated with the checkbox. So the class name is checkbox demo, and we are using an applet window. So it must extend applet, and we have to implement item listener interface. Here we are creating four checkboxes with the name WinXP, WinVista, Solaris and Max. So four checkboxes are there. First thing is we have to create these four checkboxes, and we have to add it to applet window. Then we have to register listener, item listener to each of the checkbox. So first we create WinXP is equal to new checkbox. The name of the label is Windows XP, and it does not belong to any checkbox group, so it is passed as null, and initial state is checked, so we are passing true. Second checkbox default state is unchecked. Third checkbox also default state is unchecked. Fourth checkbox also default state is unchecked. Then we have to add all these checkboxes to the applet window. Then we are registering item listener interface, sorry, item listener to the checkbox. That is, we are registering listeners to the checkbox. So whenever an event is raised by this checkbox, this listeners will get notification. Item state changed event is raised, from that it will call paint method. Next control is checkbox group. So in the previous example we saw four checkboxes and we are able to check more than one checkbox at a time, but checkbox group is a set of mutually exclusive checkbox. That means one and only one checkbox can be checked at any time. At any one time, only one checkbox in the group can be checked. That is why these checkboxes are called radio button, because they behave like a car radio. Only one station can be selected at any one time. Only one checkbox can be checked at any one time. So we have to specify the define the group first, and we have to specify define the group to which they will belong, then specify that group when you construct the checkbox. And the methods associated with this checkbox groups are get selected checkbox, and to set a checkbox we can use set selected checkbox. So we can determine which checkbox in a group is currently selected by calling the method get selected checkbox. And in set selected checkbox, the argument is which, that is a checkbox that you want to be selected. Then the previously selected checkbox will be turned off. So this is a program which demonstrates checkbox group. There is only small difference from the previous program. So class name is CB group. It extends applet. We have to implement item listener interface. We are creating four checkboxes, XP, Vista, Solaris and Mac. Then you have to define checkbox group also. Here the checkbox group name is CBG. So inside init, first define checkbox group. CBG is equal to new checkbox group. Then we have to create the four checkbox. And when you create the checkbox, you have to specify the group to which this checkbox belong. If it does not belong to any group, we have to specify the argument as null. If it belongs to any group, you have to give the name of that group. So win XP is equal to new checkbox. Name of the checkbox is Windows XP. The group to which it belongs is CBG. And its initial state is checked. Item state changed event. So this method, item state method, will be invoked. It will call repaint method. Control goes to paint method. And inside the paint method, we are displaying current state of the checkbox. So the output will be current selection is Windows Vista. So in this video tutorial, we familiarized various AWT controls. Every user interface will have three main aspects: UI elements or controls, layout and behavior. UI elements are core visual elements the user sees and interacts with. Layout define how these elements should be organized on the screen and provide a final look and feel to the GUI. And finally, behavior. These are events which occur when the user interacts with UI elements. And in the next video session, we will be discussing about remaining AWT controls like choice, scroll bar, text area, text field, etc. Thank you.